another new Patreon month.
Dude, so many great things we listened to. So we had The Last Resort by the Eagles.
We had Voodoo Child by Jimi Hendrix.
Yes, the 15-minute version. Then we also did a full reaction to the entire Revolver album by the Beatles. Every single thing we listened to defied our expectations in a completely different way.
Yep.
Amazing month.
Also, we hit the 2,000 Patreons. Go, we're like 2,100 and something now. So we are going to cover a song for you guys.
Yeah, so the poll's up there if you want to go vote for the song. We're going to try to be hitting more albums more frequently on there. But with that being said, awesome month. Can't wait to see you guys over there. See you on the video.
Hey guys, hope you're having a great day as well as a great life.
Dude, second time in the new set. Perfect Wednesday song.
Checking out some Styx, dude. I don't even remember the last Styx song we did. It was too much time on our hands. Too much time on our hands. Something like that.
Oh, yeah. Too much time on my hands. And it'll clap.
Yes. Yeah. Dude, your memory's good. All right. But yeah, we're back. New set, day two. Exciting stuff.
So before we get into it, I think this is a song that is worthy of a lyrical breakdown. So make sure you stay to the end because we're probably going to read through the lyrics, go through those.
Absolutely, dude.
That being said,
let's go and dive into it, man.
Let's get it.
Filthy!
And I dig already.
Right?
Dude, I love that, like, Eye of the Tiger vibe.
Dude,
I love their heart.
Thank you. All right, dude.
Oh, man.
That was just kind of like ridiculous. That was a lot going on, a lot of stimulation in all the right
areas.
They're so
good at writing catchy, cool songs. Like, their harmonies are so good. I love the vocal tone when they get into the harmony section. Like, it's not just like normals. It's like there's somebody whose voice is so tinny and high, but it's a great effect.
It blends really well.
Great
with
effect.
His. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I love the freaking organ, dude. It reminds me of Deep Purple in all the right ways. In all the right ways, dude. It's like so
rhythmically,
awesome.
Da 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 ba ba da 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 ba. You know.
Yeah. Shout out to what's his name, John Ward. I think. Don't butcher me if that's not his name. Okay. I think it is.
I won't butcher you.
Guitar work is crazy. Let's hold the solo on the side for a second.
Yeah.
Just the verses he's adding in.
Like textual stuff, like weird vocal accentuations. He's accenting them on the guitar,
building tension and stuff. Like
the whole
craziness,
just adding complexity and sauce in there. And the ride just fits so nice.
The ride, dude. I was like about to lose my shit the second the ride started coming in. Oh, and then the guitar solo. It's just like the solo you didn't know. Like you didn't. No one asked for it. No one needed it. And then it. Until you knew you needed it.
Yeah.
When they gave it to you.
Yeah, that's one of those things that like gives you wrinkles because you're smiling so hard. You're just mouth is open consistently.
It's like as a guitarist, you feel like the tension in his face when he's playing it. So you feel the need to also just have the tension to
grab the bottom of the chair underhand. Just like, I can't grip this enough.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
The only thing, and it's not even a bad thing, but just like an important note, I don't think I actually noticed the bass once. I don't think I noticed it. And that's not a bad thing, but I just like thought of that.
You're right. I didn't notice.
Do they have a bass player or do they have
a bass player? Yeah.
Okay.
I just know
the Doors will use the organ, like the organ player from the Doors will play the bass notes. Yeah. They get away with it. But I don't even in like Renegade do I even hear a bass either. You know what
I'm
mean?
Sure there's a bass in Renegade.
There probably is. Either way, that's a note.
It could just be production style at the time though.
Like, that's very true.
To like downplay the bass, upplay the other high end stuff.
Because there's a lot going on.
With that, lyrics?
Lyrics, let's do it.
Okay.
Lyrics
have been read.
And so as we went through it, the only thing I couldn't help but think of when the last half of freshman year in college into the sophomore year, I worked for about 13 months in a warehouse. I'm not going to say like the company name. Either way, the song reminds me so much of that because people would get in there and you could tell they needed a job, they needed work and stuff.
Yeah.
And some of these people, they would bust their freaking ass, dude.
Yeah.
And it's like just like the most like real thing, the most humbling thing to be in there. I was only working like 25 hours a week part time, but it was just the most humbling thing to like meet some of these people, talk with them, you know, and things like that. And a lot of them like really good music too.
Yeah.
Like really cool music taste. Like there's one dude who fucking would not stop talking about Aerosmith. He was like, I fucking love Aerosmith. Grew up on them. That's my shit.
Yeah.
This dude like who the Eagles was his favorite band. He loved Metallica. So lots of really cool guys and that type
Here's
of stuff.
Here's what I'll say. I love that the lyrics kind of reflect that because I've done blue collar work. I have a bunch of family that does blue collar work, and I love the idea that the whole song was saying, I don't want a handout, I want to work for what I need. Like, just give me a chance, that's all I need.
Absolutely.
Which I think is like really embodiment of like humanity's drive, kind of. Like,
yeah,
the people that are the hardest working, it's like, well, all I need is a shot, and if I have a shot, I'll do whatever. Which I think is cool. I think it's super admirable. It's really rare to have a song with. Which it didn't have crazy lyrics. Nothing was like this intense metaphor, but it was just very.
But they captured it. They captured like that concept idea and kind of conceptualized
I
it.
I really loved
it. And then put human passion underneath it with the awesome organ lines, the crazy guitar work, and you know, the passionate everything.
Yeah, so I think it's great. Rating wise, what are we thinking?
I'm thinking oh my god, dude. I'm not thinking S, but I think A plus.
Think A plus.
I don't know what would have brought it to S. Maybe if I heard that bass, you know, adding something more. Maybe it didn't need to, you know, but like maybe that would have been a factor.
Yeah.
You know?
To me, I think Renegade, I don't know what we gave it, but Renegade's an S to me.
Renegade's an S to
me.
So
I feel
well.
Like this is an A plus. I strongly agree. I think it's a phenomenal song. I think it gets across a great message. I think it's a message a lot of kids should listen to, honestly. Where it's
absolutely.
Like, don't take a handout, like work for it. Like even this, we didn't really have the money to like build, like have somebody else build an entire set. But I was like, well, I have the skill set. He has a skill set.
Let's stain some freaking wood, dude.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? No, absolutely, man. And this song kind of gave me just some newfound respect for Styx. Just because, like, I loved Renegade. I thought it was an amazing song. But this makes me like them for another reason. One, because it's like the same type, it's like the same magnitude of sauce as Renegade, but in a different direction. Yeah. But also has that really cool underlining like message and just like conceptualization of that. You know what I mean?
Which so, I didn't really get from Renegade.
Strong A plus. Cool, yeah, Renegade's like, I'm sorry, mama, I killed a man.
Yeah.
Which is, you know what I mean?
Hey, don't do that.
It's like, but no, love both songs, but this one kind of has a cool like tint to it. So yeah. A plus.
All right, man.
Well, see I guess you guys we'll, on Friday.
See ya.
That was a great song, dude. I wasn't expecting it to be like that good, honestly.